Hey everyone, Jason here, digital marketing consultant, and in this Google Analytics tutorial, you're going to learn how to use UTM parameters and the power that is at your disposal when it comes to meticulously tracking all of your links. So timestamp table of contents in the description, along with a link to a free tool that you can download. It's the exact same UTM builder that we built for ourselves and we use for our clients to stay organized. And as we go through this, you're gonna see that even though there's a free one, having your own tool is definitely going to save you a lot of time. So with that, let's go ahead and just jump right in. So before we get into the framework, how to set up your campaigns, and how to actually analyze all this new data that you're about to get, let's go through the basics of what the heck a UTM parameter is. Because you've probably seen a link something like this, where it's the URL, and then there's all this extra random text at the end of it. Well, all that extra text is telling Google Analytics specifics about where people have just come from when they're hitting your website. So the URL goes from looking something that's completely confusing and illegible to, with a little bit of color coding magic, you can start to see that there are specific elements in here that is telling Google Analytics detailed information about where someone is coming from, and you get to choose what you tell Analytics. Now, it's very important that once you come up with your URLs, you're pretty dang sure that that's what you want, because nothing we're gonna talk about here is retroactive. So you really wanna make sure you get this right the first time. Use that tool in the description to make sure everything is standardized when you're coming up with your campaigns. So now that we've got kind of the basics and the elements out of the way, let's go ahead and talk about why on earth you want to do this, and then we'll get into the framework. So inside of your Google Analytics account, you'll actually now be able to see, when you go to acquisition campaigns, specific traffic data based on the campaigns and content that you're setting up. At the end of this video, we'll go through in detail how to use these reports once you've set up your UTM parameters. But as you can see here, this particular screenshot, we are looking at all of these campaigns have been created using UTM parameters. And if we really wanted to get fancy, we can actually go look at the specific ads and specific blog posts and videos that are driving traffic. But I'm getting ahead of myself. This is the end goal that you want for UTM parameters. So let's go ahead and talk about the five elements of UTM parameters and what you can do with specifically with these to make sure that you're tracking everything that you need to be tracking. So going ahead and taking a look at this URL again, let's go ahead and break down what each one of these are. I'm gonna go ahead and add one since term wasn't on our original example. So here we have source, and this is simply just telling Google Analytics where the traffic is coming from. Medium is going to be, what type of traffic is it? Is it organic? Is it paid? Is it a referral? You can do a lot of things with this, and we'll get into an actual table of how these break down. Next, we have campaign, and this is going to be something that you specifically set. So if you have a particular sales funnel or you have a particular product or promotion, this is typically where you're going to put that name. And irrespective of where the traffic is coming from, you're going to want the campaign to represent something that you want to track, not have it tied to the traffic source. Then the next two, term and content, these are just going to be allowing you to tell Google Analytics the keyword. You're probably not going to use term very much unless you're doing pay-per-click advertising that's targeting keywords. And then content tells you the specific ad, blog post, video, Facebook post that the traffic came from. So as you can see, with these five elements, you can get really, really detailed on telling Google Analytics exactly where all your traffic's coming from. And it's awesome because as we go through those reports, you'll be able to see exactly what's working and maybe more importantly, what's not. Now, the good news is you can just head over to Google and just search UTM Builder. The first result is going to be a free tool by Google that allows you to put together these particular URLs without having to figure out all the spacing and UTM and whatnot, right? So you definitely don't have to worry about creating those yourselves. So using this tool, let's go through an example for this particular video where we want to track everyone who decides to download that free tool in the description. So we'll go ahead and type in our URL, and then the campaign source would be YouTube because we're on YouTube right now, or campaign medium would be organic because this is an organic video and we're not paying to promote it. And then the campaign name, we'll just call it UTM. By the way, you want to make sure all of this is in lowercase. Google Analytics is case sensitive. Just leave everything lowercase. Trust me, you're going to be happy that you did. A campaign term, let's just say Google Analytics because this video is about Google Analytics. And then the campaign content, this is going to be where you give your ad or piece of content a name. This particular piece of content in our internal system is called M50. And then we can go ahead and see at the bottom here that it is automatically generated our URL and we can just copy it. And technically you now have everything you need to go start building your own UTM links, but hold on, because there's something that's very important here. Remember that I just talked about Google Analytics being case sensitive? Well, you also wanna make sure that every time you're typing in these elements that they are the exact same, because if you misspell something or you call a campaign, let's say for example, this time I called it UTM for a campaign, next time I called it UTM Builder, well, Google Analytics isn't smart enough to put those two together to know that you and I were thinking of the same thing. So you need to actually standardize everything you do with your campaign tracking. So that's what we're going to go through now, because you need to make sure your data is clean, useful, and most importantly, consistent, because nothing is retroactive. So looking at this particular table, you can always come back, timestamp table of contents. This is what I recommend starting with. And if you decide to use that free tool in the description, you won't have to worry about this because we've built it in for you. Of course, you have your website URL. This is always going to change based upon what you're tracking. For campaign source, we have Google, email, Facebook, YouTube. You could have Instagram, Pinterest, Twitter, whatever the platform is, go ahead and have that be the campaign source. And then for medium, I recommend using CPC, banner, newsletter, organic, and affiliate. And so this kind of covers the entire gambit of the different types of content. So for example, we'll get into a table that takes a deeper dive. But for example, on Facebook, you could be running ads, you could also have organic posts, and then you could also have affiliates running promotions for you. And so all of that's coming from Facebook, but you need to be able to differentiate the type of traffic. And so that's where medium is really going to be valuable. Now for your campaign names, I highly recommend using a 3 to 4 letter naming convention for all of your campaign names to keep it very simple. Your campaign term, I definitely recommend only using this when you're doing paid ads. So if you're doing organic stuff, I typically don't recommend using campaign term. And then for campaign content, this is going to be where you give your ads or your blog posts or video posts or your Facebook posts a specific code. And so as you saw in the earlier example, this particular video is just called M150. So I recommend just having a letter and then a number and just keep it nice and simple. But I'll go through a table so you can really see how all of these would play out. And before we get into that table, here's a quick demo of the free tool you have access to in the description. So as you can see at the bottom here, we have a very clean table that you can change for yourself. It's very important that you standardize everything. And then if we come up to the top, all you have to do is go through the different drop-down menus, selecting the elements that are relevant to your link, and then you have a nice clean export here. You can just copy and paste that particular URL wherever your post or ad is, and you'll be good to go. And it's so important that even if you don't use our tool, you create something like this so that your campaign sources, mediums, your names, and your keywords, and your content codes are always the same, because nothing is retroactive. So let's go through a quick example. Let's say we want to track all of the traffic that's coming to a landing page. So we have some Google ads running, we have some Facebook ads running, we have YouTube, we have a blog post, and we have a podcast. We're just going crazy. We're promoting this particular offer everywhere. And so all of these are going to the same landing page. But inside of Google Analytics, we want to be able to see which one of these traffic sources and mediums and maybe the specific ad or post is actually performing the best. So to do that, we'll use the example of the link in this description for our UTM builder. So we're driving all this traffic to our UTM builder. And so our little setup here looks like this, where we have all of the traffic going to our UTM builder landing page, and then hopefully people find value in the UTM builder. So this table shows you a breakdown of how the campaign source, medium, name, term, and content would break out. So I'm gonna go through this relatively quickly. You can always pause timestamp table of contents to come back to this. So let's say we're running Google ads. Well, the campaign source is going to be Google, and the campaign medium would be PPC. Now, the campaign name will be the same for all of these because we're promoting the same offer, or this is all part of the same overarching campaign. It's all driving to the same ultimate offer, which is the UTM builder. So that's always going to be the same across all of these. Then for campaign term, this is where we tell Google Analytics the specific keywords we're bidding on so that we know which keyword is actually getting us the most traffic or the most conversions. And then the campaign content, this is where we'd go ahead and start naming our ads. ads inside of our Google Ads ad group. Now, don't worry, there's actually some advanced things you can do with Google Ads so that this can all be done automatically, but that's way out of the scope of this particular introduction tutorial. Now, let's say YouTube. This video, for example, campaign source YouTube, it's going to be organic, the campaign name is the same. We can go ahead and choose the campaign term. Now, it's up to you whether you want to be really specific or broad. In the previous example, I just said Google Analytics because we want to know how Google Analytics termed targeted videos do across our entire channel. But let's say we want to get really specific, we could say the campaign term is Google Analytics UTM tracking, and the content code is going to be M150. Now for Facebook, the campaign medium, it could be organic if we're just making organic posts on our personal page or our fan page. In this particular instance, most of the time you're going to be running ads on Facebook since organic reach is so low, and that would mean your campaign medium would need to be CPC. Now for a website, this would either be your website or it could be another website. So if it was your website, you'd put the campaign medium at organic. But if it's someone else's website, you'd put the campaign medium at referral or affiliate, just depending upon which one you like to use. Of course, the campaign name is still going to be the same, and podcasts would follow the same format. So if we were promoting on another podcast, instead of it being organic, it would be affiliate or referral. And then for email, this is where a lot of people can get tricked up. You'd go ahead and have the campaign source email and the medium newsletter. Now, there's some advanced things you can do with the campaign medium that I won't get into because it's really easy to mess things up. What I will say, though, is you definitely don't want to let your email automatically create the UTM links for you. Some of your email autoresponders out there might actually allow you to check this little box and say, do you want to track Google Analytics? You definitely don't want to check that until you've made sure that the way they track analytics is the same way you want to track analytics, especially because you're probably going to switch providers as your business grows. And so you want to make sure that you're always in control of those links and you're not allowing your email service provider to just choose what it likes. So that is a quick rundown of how your different links could turn out. Again, link in the description to that free UTM builder tool that's really going to make all of this a breeze. You only have to make the decision once, and then you just use those drop-down menus and quickly make your UTM links. So now that we've gone through all of this, I want to show you what happens on the other side. Because once you've done all this hard work of tracking, I want to show you how powerful the data you're now collecting is going to be. So you'll go ahead and take that URL, you'll paste it on whatever platform or whatever medium or place you're doing your promotion, and then you just sit back and wait for those clicks. And this is what happens when you start getting your clicks. So we're going to be using the campaigns reporting inside of your Google Analytics account to track and see how your promotions are performing. So let's go ahead and jump straight into analytics here. So we're going to click on acquisition on the side, campaigns, and then all campaigns to start. Now, when I scroll down here, you'll see that these are all of our current campaigns running. And of course, they are all lowercase. So this is being pulled straight out of our UTM URL where we put the campaign name. So these are all the campaign names straight from the UTM URL. So if we want to see some of the other elements that we have in our UTM links, we can go ahead and click on secondary dimension, and there's two places you can look. First, we're gonna look at acquisition. So if you go through acquisition, you'll be able to sort by medium. So that's where you're looking at paid versus organic versus newsletter and banner ads. And then you can look at source, which is pretty much the very top level when it comes to your traffic tracking. So then you can also go ahead and go into advertising, and this is where you're going to be able to see the campaign content and the campaign term. Again, I definitely don't recommend messing with campaign term when you're just getting started. You'll figure out what works best for you with that, but the campaign content you definitely want to have because you're going to want to know what specific blog posts, podcasts, ads, YouTube videos are actually working. So let's go ahead and go through an example here where we want to see what specific video, for us it's going to be a video, for you it might be a different type of content, is working for one of our campaigns. So we'll go ahead and click on add content here, and now we can see all of our campaigns and we can see the specific videos or ads and how their numbers are performing. Now, let's just say, because there's a lot of data here, let's go ahead and go with the first one, the sales funnel template. Which video or which ad is performing the best with the sales funnel template? So we'll go ahead and click on that, and then we'll have to go back to secondary dimension and click on add content again, and now we have all of our numbers. So what we're looking at here is we're looking at the source and medium, which in this particular instance, it's all YouTube organic because that's all we're doing for this campaign. And then the ad content represents the specific videos for this campaign. So we're looking at sales funnel template, and then we can see all of the sources and mediums, and we can see the specific videos that are performing well. And now we can answer that question of what's the best performing ad or piece of content. Apparently M15 out of the past, this is filtered for about a year. So out of the past year, that particular video has brought in 3,300 versus M22 has only brought in 7. Now this is incredibly powerful. I hope this is blowing your mind a little bit, because this is incredibly powerful when you're coming up with what type of ads to run, what type of content to make. Well, if our goal was to do more promotions, well then we'd make more videos like M15 and less videos like T31 or M22 that only got 7 or 2, right? So this, of course, will take quite a while to collect the data. But when you can get this granular and this detailed, marketing becomes a cinch, because it's no longer, oh, I don't know, what should I do for the next post or what should I do for the next ad? You just go ahead and look at this and it will just give you the answer. It's a great cheat code when it comes to content creation and driving traffic. So I sincerely hope you got some value out of this video. Make sure you check out that link in the description to the UTM Builder. It's going to make all of this a complete breeze. And within 3 to 6 months, you're going to have data just as great and juicy as this. Maybe you're not as much of an analytics geek as I am, but hopefully you can see the value in going through these extra steps to actually track your links. So go ahead and hit that like button, subscribe for more deep dive marketing videos just like this one, download that UTM Builder, and until the next, keep building the business you love.